Tamales Bay is where we're primarily located, and it's a remarkable area because it's a relatively pristine body of water. We're in our 30th year. We've made it this far. We've got over 100 employees now. We've got the land base here in Marshall with a restaurant in San Francisco, a restaurant in Napa. And one of the things that really has, that reminds me of why I do it, is when I can produce a food and watch somebody taste it right here on the shore, their eyes roll back in their head and they're just in absolute food bliss. And that to me is one of the reasons why I choose to do that business, continue to do that business.
All right.
Very nice, you guys.
Terry Sawyer loves being out on Tamales Bay in West Marin County, growing and harvesting oysters to feed a hungry market. But his work is not for the faint of heart.
This is not an easy job. Farming is difficult. Farming in the water has even more challenges.
And now Terry and his team are facing a new challenge that poses a significant threat to their business: ocean acidification.
Yeah. I have a concern that if we don't do something, we're all going to be looking at a very different ocean, a very different future.
Ocean acidification is caused by our human activities that generate carbon dioxide. We put carbon dioxide into the atmosphere by our industrial activities, by driving cars, things like that. The ocean is a tremendous sponge for carbon dioxide. It actually soaks it up. About 30% of what we put in the atmosphere ends up straight in the ocean.
Dr. Tessa Hill from the UC Davis Bodega Marine Lab says that the speed of today's ocean acidification is unprecedented in the Earth's geological record. And as the ocean swiftly becomes more acidic, oysters and other shellfish have trouble building their protective shells.
So what we see in the laboratory and in the real world is that due to ocean acidification, things like oysters grow smaller shells and perhaps weaker shells, more susceptible to predators. We need to study ocean acidification within California, and scientists need to partner with industry and with policymakers in order to tackle this problem from a lot of different angles. We at Bodega Marine Lab have partnered with Hog Island in placing sensors at their facility to try to understand how ocean acidification is impacting their business.
Got it.
Every month, Dr. Hill and her team remove those sensors and carefully analyze and communicate the detailed information they contain.
So we're asking scientific questions using those sensors, and we're turning the data over to Hog Island Oyster Company for them to use for their business purpose, to protect their business from ocean acidification. So I think it's very successful, and we're excited about expanding it.
In fact, the California Ocean Protection Council has recently directed a science panel to work with industry and policymakers to understand and inform action on ocean acidification.
What we have in place is a structure to use the best science to inform the best decisions. And furthermore, that structure has galvanized everybody who cares about the ocean in a single conversation to recognize that we need to work together, we need to talk across the aisle, and we need to work hand in hand to address these issues.
California has always been a leader in environmental issues. And when you've got policymakers that read the research, understand the information, they act in California. And that gives me great hope and optimism that we'll do the right thing for our oceans and make sure that we pay the attention necessary to deal with ocean acidification.
So what gives me hope is that there's now a community of people working on some of the big environmental challenges of our day in a way that there wasn't when I got into this business 25 years ago. I mean, the challenges are definitely greater than they ever have been, but the response to those challenges is likewise greater than it's ever been.
In California, unusual and powerful partnerships are forming to comprehend and confront the challenges of a quickly changing ocean environment while there's still time to make a difference. A sense of urgency prevails, and so does a sense of optimism and obligation.
I think that the synergy that's going on with the collaboration is something that I have never had before. And I think that basically indicates to me it's a wave, then we're getting ready to ride a wave. That's our responsibility as a society to be able to address that and take that to the future.
To find out more about the challenges of ocean acidification and California's commitment to respond, visit our website at oceanconservancy.org.